Two of her in the Lindy hop. This is Zoe.
This is Fiona.
I'm not gonna jump over you.
Okay.
Just worried you'll die.
Okay.
So today, for week two, what we introduced primarily was the Lindy circle. So we did a little bit of review over eight count and lead goes and follow goes. So and we morphed that into a Lindy circle. So what we started off with, we'll do this from the back, was the lead goes. But then you stop there, and then it's going to be basically you're facing chest towards each other, and then leads, you open up, so you're facing 90 degrees the next way, but you're still facing your column, and then you close it off, so then you're basically in the same position for a follow goes, and because you're in a follow goes position, you get out of it the same way, and so it's triple step back. So, I'll do that from this direction. So it'll be lead in front, open, close, follow back. And so that is called a Lindy circle.
Congrats.
So with that Lindy circle, you can do a couple different things. A couple of main points for it is that you kind of want to start the same place that you start, you should end back. So start here, triple step, 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 triple step. We're still in the same spot that we started. And throughout that whole entire thing, you have your chests are facing each other. So, apart from that, you also want to maintain that same sort of sitting connection that we covered in week one. So that way, it's kind of like, if you do a tap through it, it's like, whee! It's like if you're a kid swinging around like that.
And that should feel fairly comfortable. You should not be falling out.
Okay, and so what we did after that was we introduced doing multiple steps in that Lindy circle. So you always add steps in counts of two, and you always end up going back to close after having leads weight on your left foot. So a little like this, a